promise you is that we won't be defeated. I mean, I promise this city that we won't be defeated. We won't be overrun by that small group, that small element that's committing these reckless acts. We will not. I promise you that we will not be defeated.
To a terrible story now heard around the world, at least 11 killed, over 70 wounded in shootings in Chicago over the weekend. 14 of those shot under the age of 18, one as young as 11. Within a 2.5 hour time span, 25 people were shot. Now parts of the city being called a war zone. Chicago activists again demanding that the mayor and former Obama chief of staff, Rahm Emanuel, step down. Joining me now, Black Sphere executive editor and author of Race Pimping, Kevin Jackson. Is that really the only answer, that he should step down? What's your reaction?
Well, I mean, come on. Chicago has been dealing with this issue for decades. It isn't just Rahm Emanuel's problem. But the problem is that the Democrats continue to look the other way. I suggest that they plant a black Russian and say that maybe he was involved with the Trump campaign.
Oh, maybe somebody will look into it. Come on.
No, I'm just saying, you know, look, what is it going to take? People in Chicago are dying every day. And in fact, Liz, we don't know the official body count right now. They still got to go look in a few dumpsters and figure out where other bodies are. We've been following Chicago for the better part of 3 years on my radio show. And every week we give the body count on Monday. It changes by Tuesday, the number of people shot,
Kevin,
the number of people killed.
People want this to stop. There's little to no economic development in the South Side. Businesses won't go to a shooting zone. So what's the answer?
The answer is we've got to address the real underlying issues of violence in these communities. It all leads back to leadership that is liberal leadership, that claims to be progressive. It claims to care about blacks. It claims to care about all the issues and the conditions that have led to the very thing that we're discussing, and yet it solves no problems. So what do? They blame the police. I was looking at Randy Moss wore a tie that had 12 black people on his NFL induction ceremony for the Hall of Fame. 12 blacks killed over decades, and he's wearing those as a badge of honor as if police are out hunting blacks. That's not the problem. The problem is always the same in every city, whether it's Baltimore, whether it's Cleveland, whether it's Detroit, or any of the other major cities you want to name. It is the power structure being led by leftist Democrats who pretend to care about blacks when they don't. And the very blacks who are being oppressed by this are still voting these people in. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump said he would send troops into Chicago to get things fixed. I hope he does that, because Rahm Emanuel isn't going to do it. Rahm Emanuel actually said, take it to the alley when a 12-year-old was shot by gangbangers in the streets.
And here's
the thing.
He
told the gangbangers to take it to the alley.
I hear Kevin, Mayor Rahm Emanuel was out this weekend busting a move. He was dancing at a Southside music festival. And that's a neighborhood experiencing a lot of the violence. That looks like bad optics, no?
Bad optics, yes. Look. If Rahm Emanuel, and I'm going to tell you, what the leaders in these cities depend on is they depend on those very same people that create problems in black neighborhoods. They meet with them in backdoor meetings, and they divide up the city. The Rahm Emanuel does not want to solve this problem, because if he did, we would see active enforcement in these neighborhoods. Look, blacks are crying out. And meanwhile, what's Rahm Emanuel doing? He's saying, hey, Chicago's a sanctuary city. Well, you know what? Not for citizens, not for the black citizens on the west side and the south side, many of whom are under the age of 50 who are dying daily.
How do the people of Chicago react to the sanctuary city status?
Well, I would venture to tell you the average, certainly blacks, are pretty disappointed that while many of them are dying every day at the hands of the criminal element, Rahm Emanuel and the power structure are looking to bring in more illegals and pretend that there's a sanctuary city there. There is no sanctuary city in Chicago for blacks who are suffering daily from this.
Kevin, great to see you. Thanks for coming in.
You too, Liz.
Thank-